know this is a special night for you. I want to simply say, Jim, you deserve it. Congratulations. You are no doubt a great MLA. Great to have you as a friend, and I wish you all the best. And Linda, take care of them. All the best to you both. Bye-bye.
The stories are often recounted of going into a campaign headquarters, and the first thing that would be done is all the doors would come off all the rooms, well, except the bathroom.
I do think that his actual clinical care given to patients should not be forgotten because it is exceptional. From this clinical care, there evolved a continuing care for his whole community, for which we owe him a great debt.
It really was a great pleasure to work for Jim. Why was that? Well, I'll tell you, he was and is a man of integrity. The constituents in Dartmouth East recognized this when he would show up on their doorstep and discuss the issues of the day. During each campaign, Jim took responsibility to get to every door in the riding, no matter the weather, and this was no mean feat. And then there were the morning traffic waves when, before anyone was really awake.
I just want to say congratulations to you on being honored tonight here at the dinner, and I hope you enjoy yourself.
I think that swimming Nova Scotia has a claim to fame to have the on-site physician being the Minister of Health.
I just wanted to thank Dr. Smith, the 17 years that I've been with Boys and Girls Club, all the support that he's provided, not only locally to the East Dartmouth Club and the clubs in the HRM area, however, the support that he would have been giving to the Boys and Girls Club of Canada, being a board member many years ago.
I've always challenged you on everything that you did, and you've always come back with the correct answer and always right, which I appreciate, and I trust your faith and your guidance in the job you did, both as a doctor and as a politician. I think you're one of the better politicians that's ever been in the province of Nova Scotia. And I think that that has sometimes gone unnoticed, and that's very unfortunate.
I learned a lot working for Jim. I learned a lot of new swear words. I learned to always keep your cell phone on silent. I learned you could get Jim to stop on a road trip only if you could find the ice cream stand and point that out. Otherwise, you were out of luck. But I also learned you're never too busy to write a thank you note.
Good evening, Jim. It's a pleasure for me to talk about a bit of my time in the Russell McClellan government with you. You realize that the whole 9 months that I got to serve as Minister of the Crown certainly was a special memory for me. But what really struck me when I got the phone call from Russell McClellan to go into cabinet was the workload that was going to be thrust upon me, whereas guys like you with all sorts of experience really got the light load. So when I was thrust with the Department of Environment, and on top of that, responsible for the Nova Scotia Youth Secretariat, and then I see you, Jim, sitting on the other side, with all your experience, just sitting there as Minister of Health and Minister of Justice. Now really, Jim, don't you think you could have done a bit more to help us in minority government? No wonder our government fell when guys like you were not prepared to pick up their bootstraps and carry some of the load, while a young guy like me was straddled with environment and the Youth Secretariat. Did I mention that before?